Talk us through the last big play. I mean, you guys, it would seem like you were going to need one big play in that last drive to kind of get off the field, and you made it. What happened there?
We just put some pressure on them, and happily, the blitz finally opened up. All game had been closed, and it just finally opened up, and I just had to make the play for the team.
What did you see as you came up, as you come in? Your eyes get big, and you see.
Yeah, all you just see is I just seen the quarterback. That's all, and it just opened up, and I just made the play.
On the first and second play, you missed the tackle there. I mean, did you just have to kick yourself in the butt and say come back and forget about it?
Yeah, you know. I missed that tackle, and I just had to keep fighting. You know, it was a long game. Like most games in the NFL, you know, you just can't keep your head down. Just move to the next play and just, you know, capitalize on any other opportunity you get.
Did you have a good idea that you were going to get a lot of, see more extended playing time on it?
Oh, yeah. I knew that.
Bouncing back, though, is that kind of your – have you done that before? I mean,
bouncing back
from a tough play, is that kind of your
– In college, you know, I had some tough series, and I just come back, and I always find a way to make a play when it really counts.
When you're going for that sack, or you're like, God, please let me get him down. I mean,
yeah, it just happened so fast that you just got to make the play. It's right there in front of you. Just got to capitalize on it.
Was your heart pounding like crazy or?
Nah.
No.
I was just composed mm-hmm. the whole way. Mm-hmm. You know, just doing my job.
It's the biggest comeback in Browns history. I mean, how does it feel to be a part of that?
Man, it's something special, man. Just to be a part of this team and just the camaraderie we have with this bond of people here is just amazing.
Okay, thanks.